Namaste, I'm Dr. Rohit Madhurkar. I'm an interventional radiologist, been practicing for last 11 years. I'm the founding director of Pinhole Clinic and also a lead consultant at Apollo Hospitals, Bangalore. Today we are going to talk about varicose veins. So we are going to understand what is varicose veins, why it happens, how it happens, and how it can be treated permanently. So varicose veins is small bulge of veins which you see in your leg. It can happen in hands also, but it is more commonly in the legs. You can see small bulging veins in the leg, spider-like veins, small leash ones or bigger ones. So these veins bulge because the blood is not able to go back to the heart and they become more and more over years. It's a slow poison. It goes on, starts very small and keeps growing over the years. That is what is varicose veins. Now, if I have to tell you why this varicose veins happen, so I have this four P's. The four P's are, one is prolonged standing, then second thing is passed on genetically, most commonly, and then third thing is prolonged sitting, and the fourth one is pregnancy in women. Mostly it is after second or third pregnancy that we see. So these are the four reasons why varicose veins happens. Now, coming to why varicose veins happen, is there is a blood vessel. This is a blood vessel and there are valves. These are one-way valves. The valves push the blood up to the heart. So when these valves stop working, the blood is not able to go up and these blood vessels below bulge and they become more and more in number. I will show you in a small diagram on how actually this happens.
This is our leg. So in our leg, there is one vein in the center and there are side veins like this. So if you cut and see, this is our leg. This is the bone, this is the center vein, and these are all muscles, and these are all the fat around, and these two veins are like this, and these veins have a valve inside like this. So this pushes the blood up. When this fails, the blood starts going down and this starts bulging, and that's when you start getting varicose veins. You can see here, this one is a normal vein. When these valves fail, it bulges and forms. It starts as spider vein and then forms varicose veins.
Coming to the treatment aspect of varicose veins. So the treatment of varicose veins starts with conservative management, lifestyle changes to doing a procedure. It's a big spectrum of treatment that is required. Every individual, we need to tailor what treatment is required. So how do we diagnose this is very important. We do an ultrasound Doppler scan, where we do a Doppler scan of the leg and we check for these valves and the number of veins that are bulged inside. And this tells us the information whether you need a treatment and what kind of treatment is required. So now in early stages, when you see varicose veins, it's usually small spider veins and not too many. So in this case, what we have to do is mainly stockings. It does not cure varicose veins, mind that, but it will help you prolong the disease. I tell my patients that if you wear stockings, what complications you should have in 1 year may take 5 years. So stockings will help you reduce the progression of the disease, which is the first form of treatment. Following medications, I always say any drugs or medications, tablets, ointments, or even creams and tablets do not help in treating varicose veins, because this is a very simple formula. It's a structural abnormality. Imagine my hand is fractured. If my hand is fractured, I cannot apply cream and it won't become straight. So we have to fix the hand and put a plaster. Same way for varicose veins, those veins are destroyed. They have bulged, they have lost their capacity. We have to go in and treat it or close those veins, which is the principle of the treatment.